throws, but he misses just left of the upright. And this score will stay right where it is. And that one, my goodness, that was almost too easy.
Yeah, you knock out too many attempts shorter than that one. And I don't think this was blocked. That's about as bad a miss as you can have.
The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. 3-5 is where they sit on the year. A very uneven start is certainly not an ideal position to be in at the halfway point of the season. CD, do you see an avenue where they can still be a playoff team, or is that ship sailed?
Well, since you took me to the nautical side, I'm going to try and keep up here, because to me, this ship is about ready to pull out of port. These next couple of games are absolute must wins for them. Now, if they can win a couple, get to 5-5, maybe they start believing in themselves. But a loss here, that would move them to 3-6. And if that's the case, well, that boat is going to head out to the harbor with them still on the dock.
And this will be a gain of 5 as he gets it to the 30. Pretty good job defensively. Thought he was going to get it, but they knew where that marker was, and they stopped him just short of it.
What it does is emphasize that strategic football and situational football is not just played on the offensive side, is it? Defense understanding, as you noted, where the first down marker was and making sure they didn't get there.
They'll try and run for it. Here's Williams. Oh, he's got some breathing room. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. 75 yards now on the ground, just 7 carries. One thing's for sure, this defense has to figure out how to stop the ground game. He's eating him up here in the first quarter.
It looks like they have to go to different forces, aren't they? The conventional things aren't working too well. So I remember a coach of mine saying way back when a back's having a great game, you've got to get the ball out of his hands. See how far he can run without the ball. And what he meant was takeaways, not get loose, because maybe you can't just stop him with just regular tackling.
On the defensive end, Cameron Sutton with the tackle. Here's 2nd and 9, just a yard on that last run. They'll try the air now with Goff, escaping the pressure right. And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40. He turned that into a nice gain. Gets him 8 yards closer for 3rd down.
Okay, he's not going to get the first down, but this is still a nice job of buying some time and then running to get to the sideline and get out of bounds and avoid the big hit.
6-0 our score after 1. This is 3rd and 1, very likely 4 down territory, even if they don't get it, though. They'll fake the handoff. Now Goff. That'll be caught. It's the tight end, Howard. And he is going to have the Lions first down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion.
Normally on 3rd down and short yardage, you're thinking to throw to your tight end. It's just going to be a simple chain mover. But this time they let him roam down the field. And a nice dart picks up the first down, and then some.
They'll run on 1st down. Williams, he will push his way down to about the 14. This defense against the run, by the way, they're not top 5, but they are top 10.
So what's your philosophy here? Do you try and run the ball against a team that's pretty good against the run? What if you're a pretty good running team? If so, you might want to go ahead and run it anyway, because that's your strength.
Throwing on 2nd and 8, Goff. It's caught on the right side, Williams. No gain on the play, and it'll bring up a 3rd down.
As a defense, you're more balanced when you're in zone coverage because you're able to keep your eyes on the quarterback and see the play develop in front of you. You're able to keep the quick pass in front of them and stop it right at the line of scrimmage.
Throwing on 3rd, Goff. And it's intercepted at the goal line. Picked up by Minka Fitzpatrick. No doubt, a very disappointing end to what was a pretty strong opening drive.
They had 3 points in their back pocket. It was there for them. If you don't like what you see, just throw it away. Make sure you get those points on the board. Don't get too greedy. He forced it there. You saw the end result.
The Pittsburgh offense at the line to start their next drive.
4-4, their record through 8 games on the season. Would you say that this team has overperformed, underperformed, or are they kind of right where you thought that they would be?
Do you mind if I say yes, yes, and yes? Because ultimately, to me, 4-4 is about where they should be, because we've seen weeks where they've been really, really good. They've looked terrific. Other weeks where we've wondered, just how good is this team? They want to be consistent in their play, not consistently inconsistent, which is what they've been thus far.
Hey, alert, 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 alert. On second and very short, Roethlisberger able to hit his target, Claypool. And he gets this up across the 35 before he's out of bounds. Second catch for him today, and it'll wind up a first down. Play action. Now Roethlisberger. Claypool with another catch. 5 yards on the catch there. Brings up second down.
Fired that one in there. Able to make connection on a nice in route.
With those faster passes when they're going that fast, any hesitation as a quarterback that the deflection, if you miss, might be bigger and lead to an interception?
Yeah, and the deflection works both ways. Maybe a defender gets a hand in the way and it pops in the air. And sometimes you throw it so hard your receiver can't handle it and he pops it up in the air for the defenders to grab as well.
But a moot point there as they were able to connect. And tackled down after a gain of 3. Leaves him with 1 yard to go on third down. Play action. It's Roethlisberger. Quick hitter here. It's complete. And they'll work this down to the 40-yard line. Tackled there. 14 yards through the air. Caught the D off guard on third and one. On first and 10, it's Roethlisberger.
Quick slant, finding Claypool.
And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard.
Nothing fancy on first down, but a very consistent type of a play. Hit that slant. A lot of people call it an extension of the running game. And it can be if that pass is completed. Because you hit a guy on the run like that, you often can go for big yardage.
Sets him up nicely for second down, staying ahead of schedule. They missed a field goal on their last drive. Here they need something to even get into field goal range on third down. Trying to pick it up on the ground with Harris. And he's able to pick up the first before he's taken down at the 27. A third down gain of 3 yards, and that'll be enough. 2 minutes remaining in this first half of football. A reminder, once we hit halftime, as we do all season, we'll send it down to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. He'll have all the stats and scores from games in progress around the NFL.
The best multitasker in the business, the coach.
That is caught by Smith-Schuster. And he will reach the 8-yard line before going out. The passing game in rhythm right now for Pittsburgh. There's another first down. They run with Harris, and he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. No gain on the play that time, and it sets up second and goal. Now it's Roethlisberger. And a dangerous throw there as that's knocked down and incomplete.
Quarterbacks work all the time on manipulating a defense with their eyes and their head movement. In this case, he just stared the receiver down. That allowed for excellent coverage, able to knock that one away.
They've been denied touchdowns in the red zone twice already. Here comes third and goal. Off the play fake. Here's Roethlisberger. Flushed out right. He's got Claypool for a Steeler touchdown. Chase Claypool, his sixth touchdown of the season. And the Steelers are an extra point away from taking the lead.
And I believe they buzzed down. They're going to take another look at this play with all reviews coming from the replay official here in the final 2 minutes of the half. So they called it a touchdown originally, and this will stay a touchdown after the video review, so they had it right.
So back even at six apiece as the kick's away. Khalif Raymond now. And he'll be tackled just shy of the 25. Offense ready to kick off their next drive. And the interception thrown in the red zone last time. We'll see if they can rebound.
I just have to think the last thing he said is they went.
And he's going to be taken down. Goff is sacked. The Steelers signal for the second of their timeouts. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. Now then, after the sack, it'll be interesting to see what they have planned for second and 23. Another try after the first down sack. Goff. Man open, here is Jones. The Lions will use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with a tick under a minute to go before half. Just like that, out of danger and up past the 40 now for first and 10. From the gun, here's Goff.
This one swung out to Williams.
Yeah, he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40. The catch and run there, good for 16 and a first.
Another catch for him there on this drive, Brandon. It looks like they're going to utilize him out of the backfield any way they can. And that time, they pick up a first down. So now on defense, do you assign a man to him and try and cover him before he gets going?
Now Goff on first down. Forced out to his left. Nothing open downfield, so he'll throw it away.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Throwing again is gone.
Open man is Raymond. He's got it.
And they went the wrong way there. Losing yardage back at the 43-yard line. 2 yards the loss, and now third and 12. A shotgun snap for Goff. He's going to let this one go deep. And unable to connect. Incomplete. Now give them credit. They took their shot, but it's going to bring up fourth down.
They went with a dime look on defense. Two extra defensive backs on the field and covered up essentially every blade of grass. That allowed them to disrupt the play.
The NFC's Pro Bowl punter a year ago, Jack Fox, on to punt for the Lions. Ray McLeod deep for Pittsburgh.
And now a fair catch called for, and he'll indeed take it at about the 6-yard line. 33 yards is the distance on the punt there. And control of the football, switching hands with very little time remaining until the half. Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. And they'll begin inside their own 10, so field position certainly not in their favor here. They'll indeed start on the ground to run that clock. And he'll just push his way forward for a few as the clock will run. And with just 4 seconds left in this first half, a timeout called. And you see the clock almost empty, so this is likely the last play in the second quarter. They'll keep it on the ground again here. And they'll get him down up past the 15, just shy of the 20. So we have reached halftime here with not much scoring between these two teams. 6-6 our score as we'll head down to Orlando. That's where we find our man Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach! Okay, Coach, yeah, adjustments likely going to play a big role in this third quarter in what's been a tight contest so far. Forecast calling for more of the same. The rain set to continue as we are underway in the second half. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Pittsburgh offense at the line to start their next drive. It's a tie football game here. What do you think, Charles, the message was at halftime?
Well, I think that they probably just looked at things and said, we're fortunate that this is a tie game. No need to panic. No need to change a whole lot. We didn't play anything close to our best in the first half, so we don't have to go out and win one for the Gipper. Let's just go out and play our best football and win one for us.
Second and six. Now Roethlisberger, and they get to him with a pressure as Roethlisberger goes down.
We are seeing two really confident defenses imposing their will on these offenses in this game.
Yeah, absolutely, going toe for toe. Just curious if one of these offenses can wake up a little bit.
Is there any way they can find something that can pop, something big to knock them back on their heels?
On third down, Roethlisberger. He'll get this to his tight end. That's Pat Freiermuth. And he will have a Steelers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Roethlisberger will throw. Ebron caught left side. Not a big window to throw. Coverage wasn't too bad there.
Yeah, they had him under wraps pretty well, but somehow able to muscle his way open and catch the ball.
From the 41, Roethlisberger. And that falls to the ground, incomplete. A nice job of bodying him up defensively, and now it brings up third down. So, Charles, tie game here. What are your keys as we continue to play this second half?
I know people think it's always trite when you say the same things over and over, but they're tried and true in the game of football. Who's going to block better? Who's going to tackle better? In this case, to me, it's turnovers. You've got to take care of the football in order to win the game.
They go play action now. Roethlisberger. That ball caught by the former Toledo Rocket, Deontay Johnson. He was held without a catch in the first half, but he's got one here, and he also picks up a first down. First down. To throw here, Roethlisberger. That swung out wide to Harris. And they'll wind up getting this to the 37. Gain of 9. Here's second and a yard. On the ground, it's Harris. And he'll go down here at the 35-yard line. 2 yards, good enough for a first.
Second and one, and people want to run the football. This is where every back in the league is supposed to do exactly what we just saw there. Pick up the first down.
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. On the jet sweep, this is Johnson. Call it a full 3 yards in the wrong direction there. Brings up second down.
Well, as a wideout, when you take that handoff and you're coming around the edge, you're expecting to see nothing but empty space in front of you. But if not...
Well, things can go south in a hurry, and that's exactly what we saw on that play with a loss.
That loss of 3, a rare stumble on a promising drive. Here's second and 13. They go play action with Roethlisberger. He finds his target, Ebron. And all the way inside the 15 before they drop it. That one covers 24 yards. It's a first down. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. And he's got it. And in for the Steelers' touchdown. Eric Ebron, his second touchdown on the season. And the Steelers have taken the lead.
As a general rule, quarterbacks don't want to lock in on a receiver before the ball is snapped. But in this case, based on the matchup he thought he was going to get, it was favorable for his tight end. He locked in on him early and found him for a touchdown.
Boswell now to kick it away after the touchdown. Here's Khalif Raymond to return.
And the tackle going to be made right there at the 25-yard line.
The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. And this game was all square at halftime, but now they find themselves down 7 following the opening drive touchdown here in the third quarter.
And they need to take a good, relaxing, deep breath, don't you think? Because right now they might start to feel like they've got to play catch-up here and start matching them point for point. But it's still too early to get there. They can still run their offense. Plenty of time to get back in this game.
And this will wind up a Lions first down as the tackle made here at the 36.
We don't talk about it very often, but sometimes there's a dip in intensity when you start the second half, which can manifest itself in some sloppy tackling. And how about right there? He ran right through that weak tackle attempt.
On first down, it's Williams. And unable to get downhill there as he'll take this up to about the 37. You know, despite the scoreline, I think they've got to like where they are here. They're on the road and just one big play away from getting right back in this game.
I'm going to follow right along with you because the spot they're in now is a credit to their defense. They've kept them in it by making the plays that they've made, and that just means you're one big score away from being right back there.
Now, the question is, can this offense step up and make that play? Because that's been an issue for them in this game. Only three there on the pickup, but that's enough to move the chains. Under a minute to go in this third quarter as they come up first and 10. They go back to the ground, this time Swift. And he'll be taken down at the 44-yard line.
On any explosive run, you can almost feel the ground shaking, and that's from the offensive lineman creating space for their runners. I had an old coach tell me before that he always told his runners, run around the offensive line in pregame. Get used to the ground shaking so you don't trip and fall when it happens in a game.
And he'll be brought down, it looks like, right at the 40. 4 yards the pickup, first down.
A gain of 4 yards. First down, Lions.
And that is going to do it for this third quarter of action. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. The drive continues as they search for a time touchdown. Here's first and 10. Go off a handoff here to Swift. And little room to maneuver there. He gets it down to about the 39. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and 9.
Well, sometimes you just have to give credit to the defense. Great job there at the point of attack, holding up. They won their battles at the line of scrimmage, left him no space to try and run. A really nice job swarming to the ball carrier.
They'll try the air now with Goff. They're going for Howard, but the pass intercepted. Picked off by Melvin Ingram.
Brandon, offensively, this has been a tough day for them. Trying to find a place to throw the football. It's been extremely difficult. I've got to give a lot of credit to the secondary, especially the corners who've had the receivers on lockdown.
After the interception, here's Roethlisberger. And that'll be incomplete.
From the snap, he certainly looked like he knew where he wanted to go with the ball, but surprise, that guy was covered. So that took his attention elsewhere to no avail.
To throw on second and 10, Roethlisberger. And this throw incomplete. And the defender all over him that time, but it's going to lead to third down.
He did a fine job there of not hitting it before the ball arrived, and I've got to tell you, you can often mistime that play because of the angles of approach. When you're going to get him, sometimes you panic as well and think, I've got to be there right now. Instead, in this case, timed it perfectly and knocked it free.
From the gun on third down, it's Roethlisberger. And he'll be corralled out across midfield down to the 45. 7 catches for him now, and this last one, a first down. He's been the go-to guy. They needed a big play there on third down. Went his way, it worked out.
Doesn't matter whether they've scouted it or that they think he's going to get the ball. He has a knack for finding his way open and completing the connection.
Now a first down carry for Harris. He'll get it to the 40. Broke a tackle there to get some extra yardage. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and 5. Now it's Roethlisberger. And his throw is going to be incomplete. They don't get the hookup there, but you really have to marvel at how precise he's been throwing the football these last couple weeks.
Oh, that's the perfect word for it, precise. Because if you're at 70% or better 2 weeks in a row, You have a job as long as you want one in this league, won't you? I mean, let's face it, it's not just West Coast offense either. He's putting the ball downfield as well.
And he gets it to the 32. Good enough for a first down. 54 yards rushing for him now as his fine rookie season continues. From the 32 now, here's first and 10. Play action. Now Roethlisberger. Oh, no, he lost the football. And this is scooped up by the Lions. Taking it right down Broadway. Past the 20. And into the end zone. A scoop and score. And a fumble return for the Detroit touchdown. So they were down by a touchdown, probably just hoping the defense could hold them, maybe force the punt. Instead, they forced the turnover and take it into the house.
Well, the plan was perfect. That's exactly what they wanted. Instead, they got a lot more than that. Big-time capitalization by taking the ball away and putting it in the end zone.
All square now at 13-all as he sends this one away. And a short kick taken at about the 16. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28. The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. And the question, can they turn that interception into points? A tie game for the moment in the fourth quarter. A handoff to Harris to begin the drive. And nothing much materializing there on the first down run. He'll get a couple and that's it.
Certainly a nice job there by the defense rallying to the football and getting him on the ground. But I think the play gets made by the defensive front, because if they can't get upfield, their job is to go ahead and get low, almost get into a ball sometimes, stack things up, and make it difficult for the runner to find a hole.
From the 30 on second down, Roethlisberger. Flush to his right, and he's out of bounds, able to take this one up to the 35. He'll end up getting five out of that, but now they're looking at third down. They run with Harris. And he will be very close to a first down, but I see the closed fist of the referee, and that means fourth down. Call it a three-yard gain, and it'll be fourth down. And this is going to be nowhere close. Needed some inches and ended up losing yardage. The Steelers try it, but they come up empty on fourth down. And the Lions will get the football back in terrific field position. They'll run on first down. It's Williams, and he'll work this forward for about three at second down.
Let's give a lot of credit to the offensive line. They've been able to move the ball really well on the ground the entire game, and while that wasn't a huge one, that's okay. They'll take him in short, steady bursts.
Williams going to get it again on second down. Williams is going to have the first down and a little more. And he'll finally be taken down at the two-yard line. All told, it's an even 30 and a first down.
Another carry for their leader and a good one. It's crunch time. They'll need him to continue to be productive in both the run and passing game in order for them to try and snatch victory.
Williams. Able to get a couple here, but won't get across the plane as they stop him right around the one. Now, what's the thinking here? Because a touchdown would be nice, but you've ensured yourself a chance at three in the lead, so how worried are you about the six?
You're not very worried about if you're confident in your kicker. And if you got a kicker who can put it through the post, you feel really good about trying to bleed that clock down. In an ideal scenario, your kicker puts it through the post as the clock hits zeros.
Getting down to the good stuff. All tied with 2 minutes remaining on EA Sports. So the Lions in possession of the football as we welcome you back. They've got it second and goal as they look to grab a late lead.
They'll run with Swift.
And he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Detroit.
DeAndre Swift
with touchdown number 7 on the year. And the Lions have broken our tie as they take the lead.
Hey, that score deserves our respect, deserves our excitement. But I'm looking at the clock, and I'm thinking, there's a long way to go in this one.
Ideally, they would have liked to milk a little bit more time off. Now, on the other sideline, you start to get the crew together and say, this is what we practiced the two-minute drill for, right?
Yeah, you hope you've been in that situation before, and if you haven't, you just have the confidence, hey, let's go down there and get this thing done. But boy, that's a big score right there to give them the advantage.
The Pittsburgh offense at the line to start their next drive. And last time this unit was out here, costly turnover, and then that turned into 6 points. They've got to make amends.
And how many times have we sat in meetings with coaches and they use the term complementary football? Offense take care of the defense, defense take care of the offense. That didn't happen on the last possession. This is a chance for them to pick themselves back up and help their team.
Yeah, we'll see if they can recoup and recover. Here's Ben. He's got Smith-Schuster. Oh, he's got a little daylight. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. That'll go as a pickup of 32 on the catch and run.
Oftentimes now, offenses aren't nearly as precise as days gone by. They just help receivers find an open patch of grass and let the quarterback find you. And that's exactly what they did on that play. First with the pass through the air, nice chunk of yardage there, and then additional pickup with his legs after the catch.
Now Ben. He finds his man, Johnson. And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it, so it's not that big of a deal to me, and I'm going to keep firing.
Roethlisberger. Trying to get it to Ebron, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Obi Melifonwu. 30. 10. And he will bring it back. An interception return for a Lions touchdown. So this defense doubling its pleasure there. Remember, they had the fumble return for a score earlier in the game, and now this time an interception return for another score. The point after, through the raindrops, up and good. And the lead now up to 14. Steelers 13. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. A short kick taken at the 18. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line. The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. And last time, decent field position through the pick six. Obviously costly.
But they can't afford to just bunker in now. All right, good field position means go ahead and attack on offense. Try and press the advantage a little bit. They just have to be better with the football on this possession.
So the last one, that didn't bother you too much last time?
No, because it's exactly what you're supposed to do. You can't have good field position and not try to take advantage of it. Sometimes the defense makes a good play, too.
Then's throw complete there to Johnson. And he's got this down to the 35. Now the Steelers use the second of their three timeouts, as the clock's going to stop with 47 seconds to go in the fourth. Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. Now Roethlisberger eluding the pressure. And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. Now the Steelers going to use their third and final timeout, as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the game. Well behind the sticks here with a second and 18.
77. Three down. Hey, check. Three down. Let's go.
Here's Roethlisberger.
Check.
Steps away to his left. Now he's going to go up top over the middle. And at the 7-yard line, the catch is made. And he's going to be taken down here with a penalty flag on the field. Now that's one they hate. The ball's got to come all the way back.
So that's an explosive play, a really explosive play that gets wiped out, and they have to start over after the penalty.
They run it with Ballage, and he's going to be stopped up at about the 47-yard line. Just a gain of two there, and it's going to bring up a fourth down. Here we go. It's Roethlisberger on fourth down. That's to his running back, complete. And they will stop him short of the marker. Now, there is a flag here, but if this is on the offense, and I think it is, they'll obviously decline it. So they elect to decline it.
And why not? Just go ahead and let the play stand, and they'll take that.
So the special teams penalty costs some yardage there as they come out on first and 10. A handoff, Swift running to the left. And a good swarm to the football defensively as they get him down at about the 40. So this one's over. It's a win for the Detroit Lions. And they were buoyed, Charles, by a big second half that put this one on ice.
So you get the sense that whatever was said at halftime obviously hit home. I think it's a little bit more than that, though. Obviously, there are words that are said, and hey, come on, guys, we have to play better. But sometimes it's just sharpening your execution, sharpening your focus, and maybe doing the things you practiced all week without major adjustments, just doing them better. And that got it done in this one.
So for Detroit, it's an important win for their postseason hopes as they at least get back to 4-5. And they'll get another road test next week as they head to Cleveland to take on the Browns. Meanwhile, for the Steelers, they are barely afloat as they fall to 4-5. And they will try to get back in the swing of things next week on the road.
Yeah. gone, so I'm spake. I'm gone, long for a deep for me. This ain't come from the league, I got money, take care of mass. Ride to the wheels, don't crash, and I hit whoever, long as we get past. Take it back to pay our touchdown. Whoever thought I'd have a bust down, still sticking to the strip going deep. Still trying to take care of my people. Football ain't all I know, that was all I chose. Back to the road for me. If I'm from bad, don't know how we gon' need that step. Just let a young no sad step. I never knew my broke down. Ready to see it here, don't be too low, no, I need my lead. First we sit him, y'all know I can't catch. Send him to the bench, I done lost wrong speak. I'm gone down. Ready to see it here, don't be too low, no, I need my lead. Sit him, young dog, can't catch. Send him to the bench, I done lost all respect. I'm gone.
Just for fun.